Welcome to the channel, and this is the first episode which will document our journey by motorhome all the way from Cork to Roscoff in France, down through France, over the Pyrenees, and to the west coast of Spain to Santiago de Compostela. So, the crossing from Cork to Roscoff was pretty rough, with me rolling left and right in my bed the whole night with very little sleep. But we disembarked at Roscoff and headed straight to Morlaix. Now, Morlaix is famous for its very impressive aqueduct, and we also get to explore some of its cobbled streets with old medieval wooden buildings. Now, having stocked up on baguettes at Morlaix, the plan was to head straight to Nantes, which is about 4 hours away, and spend the night there. But sometimes it's about the journey and not the destination, so we never made it to Nantes. However, we did discover this amazing motorhome Aire not far from Rennes, so we stayed there instead. So keep watching to find out more. So we barely made check-in at Ringakiddy yesterday. It's actually very stressful. We just arrived there an hour before departure. Oh, that's nice here. I'm going to show you that. Let's just look at that. After a visit to the supermarket, some French cheese and a bite to eat, we headed down to the waterfront, turned right, and there before us was the most beautiful aqueduct. The Viaduct du Morlaix was first opened in 1865. It's 62 meters high and is 292 meters in length. Now just under the viaduct is the Church of Sainte-Melaine. The church was built at the end of the 15th century by the Beaumanoir workshop of architects. The church is built in flamboyant Gothic style and is dedicated to Sainte-Melaine de Rennes. So we continued up here, up this little street, and we came across what are called Maisons à Pendelet, which means overhanging houses. Now these were constructed in the 16th century by linen merchants, and they were built on three stories around a monumental fireplace, a winding central staircase, and wooden indoor walkways named Pont d'Alais. Thank you. to get to Santiago de Compostela in northwest Spain. Kind of a little pilgrimage. This is day one. See if we get there. We have 3 weeks to do it and get back. Will we make it? Who knows? I don't know. Few issues with the camper on and off, mechanical issues, and so it really a lot depends on that. Spot to park up for the night. Now just over there with my fingers pointing, we actually pulled in there to a car park for lunch, and then I took a stroll and saw there was a paid place across the way. So we crossed from Roscoff last night, and boy was it rough. I mean, we just raced. We just got to Ringakiddy in Cork about an hour before, just basically in time for check-in, which was grand, and we did manage that. I said, you know what, we just saw the sign for this town, we saw the Motorhome sign, services area. I said, look, let's just try this. And we pulled in and we found that car park there, and I took a stroll across here, over here, and then I found the paid place. And so went back to the van and said, you know what, I'm just too tired. Let's just get a good night's sleep. Let's stay here, relax for the day. And we found it quite by accident. It's about 6:40 per night and €2 extra for electricity. Now we went to bed around, I'd say about 6 o'clock. On the ship, this group of about 10 teenagers decided to congregate outside the door. They were just so loud. I might have got my time frames mixed up. Now we're not going to walk all the Camino or anything like that. We're just going to drive along. We'll probably do a bit of walking here and there. And actually, where I've walked now is somewhat uninspiring. But let's walk back over here. Let's look at the jogger. She goes another lap.
Run, Forrest, run!
We were really planning to come into France and go north to the Netherlands and into Denmark maybe, and we'd recently watched the movie The Way with Martin Sheen. If you haven't seen it, I do recommend it. It's a good movie. And so we said, yeah, that's not a bad idea. Let's drive along. Let's go to Santiago. So this is day one. This is Broons. It's kind of an ideal spot if you've had a terrible crossing, you're dog tired. That's a lovely place just to start off, reset yourself, get a good night's sleep in a lovely environment. And it's spelled B-R-O-O-N-S. And it's a really fabulous place. It's very relaxed, not expensive. Nicely laid out, you know, there's electricity there, some nice pitches, grass and hard pitches. And I just have another look there now again. It's getting dark.